Hey there guys, Paul here from theengineeringmindset.com. In this video, we're going to be looking inside one of these, the Hermatic Filter Dryer by Danfoss.
Coming up, what are they used for? Where do we find them? And then we'll cut one open and look at all the parts inside and discuss the purpose of each bit. If by the end of this video, you still haven't had your fill of filter dryers, then I suggest you head over to Danfoss Learning and dive into their collection of free e-lessons. Danfoss is passionate about sharing knowledge, so in addition to sponsoring this video, they've also made hundreds of e-lessons available for free on their website, including multiple courses on filter dryers. You can find all of it by following the link in the video description down below. Where do we find these filter dryers? This is a very typical model filter dryer, and we'll find these installed in the liquid line of the refrigeration system between the condenser and the expansion valve. We've covered how expansion valves, heat exchangers, and refrigerants work in our previous videos. Do check those out, links are in the video description down below. On the side of the filter dryer, you'll find an arrow. This indicates the direction of refrigerant flow. Some models for heat pumps might be bi-directional, and the arrow will point both left and right. But in this case, we have a single direction, one-way filter dryer. On the outside, we have a powder painted surface, which just prevents corrosion, and the black gloss finish just gives a premium look and feel. The casing is made from steel to give it a strong structure, as this will be under some high internal pressure once connected into the refrigeration system. At each end, we have some solder connections, which can either be pure copper or copper plated, depending on the model. So what do we use a filter dryer for? Well, these are found in refrigeration systems, and as you might guess from their name, their job is to filter and dry the refrigerant. They protect the refrigeration system and its components by capturing and absorbing water particles as well as harmful solid substances. This will prevent them from cycling around the system and getting into the compressors, the valves, the sensors, etc. to keep the system running at optimal conditions. Anyway, enough about that, let's cut it open and look inside of the components. I'm just going to use a slit disc and the angle grinder to cut this one open. I'm going to start with a fresh disc just to get the maximum cutting depth. Then I'll lock the filter dryer into the bench vise to stop it moving around. Then we can just slice through it nice and easy with the grinder. As I said, the casing is made of steel, so we're going to get a lot of sparks flying around the workshop, so we have to make sure we're wearing some protective gear and also move any flammable materials out of the way. I'll just reposition this in the vise to get my second cut at roughly 90 degrees to the first, just to let us look inside. Alright, that's the casing cut open, let's pull it apart to look inside. So as we remove the casing, we instantly see some of the key components inside, the biggest component being the solid core, but we'll look at that in just a moment. Now, at the refrigerant inlet end, we have a large spring. I've actually cut through this one so it has lost its shape and I can just pull the remaining parts of that out. But the spring just pushes against both the casing and the solid core. This is just there to keep the core in a fixed position inside the casing. Next, we have the core or the molecular sieve. This particular model has a solid core, 80% of which is a molecular sieve and 20% is an activated alumina. I'll show you some close-ups here of that porous material. The solid core molecular structure acts as a filter to capture any large dirt particles. The material is similar to a sponge in that it can soak up and retain water. The aluminium or aluminum oxide is added in there to capture and retain the acids. Not all filter dryers will have activated alumina inside them, it depends on the application. So the refrigerant enters and surrounds the outside of the core. The pressure of the system forces the refrigerant to pass through the porous material. Notice this groove inside. The refrigerant will pass through the solid core and then collect in this groove to continue its flow towards the expansion valve. At the end of the solid core, we have a screen. This polyester mat retains the smaller dirt particles which might have been able to pass through the solid core. The material is able to capture dirt particles down to 25 microns with minimal pressure drop. After the screen, we have a perforated plate. This is just there to keep all the internal parts in position. The holes just allow the refrigerant to flow to the outlet. The refrigerant then leaves the filter dryer and heads to the expansion valve. So the refrigerant enters through the inlet, it passes across the spring and then surrounds the outside of the solid core. The spring is pushing and holding everything in place. The refrigerant then passes through the solid core, and as it does so, the dirt, moisture and acids are absorbed. The refrigerant then collects in the groove at the center of the core and then it passes through the screen. It then passes through the perforated plate and exits the unit, having been filtered and dried. The refrigerant then continues to the expansion valve. Ready to continue your education on filter dryers? Then head over to the Danfoss Learning webpage now and start your first course for free. Just follow the link in the video description below. Okay, that's it, but if you want to continue your learning, then just click on one of the videos on screen now and I'll catch you there for the next lesson. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and of course, theengineeringmindset.com.